something, and then I figure, well, you know what, let me just double check before I put foot and mouth here. Let's see if I'm getting close to where I think I am here. Where to go? Okay, yeah, now I was about to put foot in mouth. Alright, that was close. Well, I could still say haha, because we're down to 165, give or take, miles to Phoenix. Which is a good thing, and we're currently now on Highway 62, headed essentially due east. And we're going to take that on down about 15 miles and then bang a right, heading south on, not sure if it's going to be called 72 or 95, or I think it's going to be called 72. Looks like it might be called 95. I know, it's a little uncertain. It might be a multitude of things, I don't know. It looks like it's 95 and then 72. Yeah, something or another, but in any event, here shortly, we will be crossing the state line over into Arizona at somewhere near Big River. That should be the Colorado River coming up, I believe, in a matter of a few miles, I think. I'll tell you this, it's definitely a nice road surface. For sure. Nice and smooth. Great, I love it. What a difference it makes when you actually got a smooth roadway to drive on. All the less stress. Easier on the truck and easier on the body, I guess, the body-mind. Some of the highways, interstates, even for that matter, man, when you're driving on, like, just screwed up road surface for 100 miles or, 20 miles, even just 20 miles on just a road just full of potholes and bumps, uneven stuff, it'll take its toll. It does. It's like, it can get pretty aggravating. Things shaking around and bouncing around all over the place, falling. Probably the thing that drives me the most nuts, the most bonkers in that regard, is my seatbelt latching up on me, because it'll do that just from bumps in the road, potholes. It'll like tighten up on me and I won't be able to like lean forward or nothing, and it's a very claustrophobic kind of feeling to be restrained like that. Tell you what, this is exactly the kind of area where you want to come if you want to go off-road. You got a dirt bike or a little dune buggy or something like that. This is exactly where you want to be. This is where you want to go. See, like these folks over here. We got their little RV all set up. There's a bunch of them out there actually. Kind of just like spread out all over the place. I had a dirt bike once in a past life, a little XR 200, 1990 XR 200, and it was a four-stroker, so it wasn't like super crazy acceleration on it, but it was pretty good for even for a 200. But it was dependable as all hell. I mean, that thing would start up and run, and it would bog. It would bog its way up any little hill climbs with very little problem. But it was just super dependable. It would always start, no problem. Even if it sat for a year not being started, it would still fire right up every time. And it was like, it was a cushy bike. It was like the suspension on it, I had pretty loose on it, on the front and the rear. So it was a... It was a super cushy ride, like riding on a lazy boy chair, just bogging through the dirt. And then I also, in an even more distant past life, had a Suzuki Katana 600. That was a 91, I think, if I remember right, or maybe, I think it was a 91. Or no, 97, something like that. No, 94, that was it, 94. Suzuki Donna 600. Dual exhaust. And that thing got up and go. It was a pretty fast bike for 600. So I'm not a very heavy guy, and I was probably even lighter back then than I am now. And that thing was definitely, it put you back. That was a fun bike. I probably had the most fun on that bike than I had on my XR. Beans, turkey, here we go. Seeing trucks come out from the direction that I plan on going is a good sign. It always is. Make it official here as we go over the Colorado River. Man, that is pretty down there. Boy. Palm trees and everything. Here we go. Welcome to Arizona. It's official. Welcome to Park. Parker, Arizona, for that matter. guess we're going to kind of ride along with these guys pick up the cones. Look at that lead truck up there, if you can see it. It's just cruising along there. Guy in the back picking up cones one by one.